Here's an improper integral where the limits are perfectly fine, but the function is undefined inside the interval. So here is your integral right here. And you see that the integrand, 1 over 4 minus theta squared, is undefined at theta equals 4, which is between 3 and 6. So there's nothing wrong with 3 and 6. Except that at 4, the function is undefined. And that might cause trouble, it might not. Here's a graph over here, and we see that the area involved is here, up against this asymptote right here, and this area. So this function goes on up to infinity that way, and positive infinity that way. The question is it close enough to this asymptote here so that this area that's adding up going that way is going to converge to a finite number? From what we've seen so far, it looks like this curve is pulling away, not away, but there's just too much space there. So we're guessing it probably diverges, but we don't really know 100%. Okay, so here's the area region, all in here and all in there. Okay, so just poking around with some technology, we run the integral program just as it is, 3 all the way to 6, and just see what happens. Get a pretty large number that doesn't look promising for converging. It looks like it might diverge. But we'll see. Then maybe just do from 3 to 4. Here's 4, where the asymptote is. Just do this area and see what happens. From 3 to 3.9999, you still get a pretty large number. And let's see what really happens here. Okay, so the idea is for the integral to converge, both 3 to 4 and 4 to 6 must converge. And if they both do converge, then the original integral converges to the sum of those two. But if either one does not converge, then the original integral does not converge. Okay, so first let's just take one step at a time. Let's investigate the left side over here, 3 to 4. So that's by definition, since at 4 the function is undefined, we're going to inch up towards 4 from the left, going towards 4 with your B. So now let's just concentrate on what this is. We're just going to integrate this inside, which you might be able to do without going through all this U substitution, just by fumbling around trying to get the antiderivative, because it's not very hard. But by doing all the steps of the U substitution, it would come out to be this right here. Okay, and somewhere along the line, I think I switched it around, theta minus 4 instead of 4 minus theta. That's only okay because of the even exponent, making the plus or minus be the same answer. Okay, then we say that the integral from 3 to b is that antiderivative evaluated at 3 to b. And that all works out with your mathematics and algebra to this. So then, the limit is 4, b goes to 4 from the left side of this integrand, is equal to the simplified expression that we had. And here's where you have to do a little bit of thinking. B is going to 4 from the left. That means you're inching up. You're at numbers like 3.99 minus 4. So that's a negative number right here. This is negative. So a negative times a negative is going to be a positive, and then you get this minus 1. But the idea is that this denominator is going to zero, and therefore going to infinity, and since it's negative times a negative, you get a positive infinity. So it is plus infinity, but that really does not exist. So that integral does not converge. And since both 3 to 4 and 4 to 6 must converge for the original integral to converge, this means that the original integral diverges or does not converge.